For the last few months, DUTA has been trying to impress upon the government and at the level of the UGC that the kind of schemes that they're trying to bring about, namely a few, whether you call it the schemes on the HEFA, H-E-F-A, whether on graded autonomy, whether on the funding schemes, whether on the autonomous colleges, all this would be anti-teacher, anti-higher education and anti-students. And added with it came the 7-pay review recommendations for teachers and the related pay commission and service conditions. Because teaching is different, but it is only teachers as employees that you have, that every pay commission you have a different set of service regulations that always comes upon us. It is not that any other employee, they have the same service conditions, but it is only when it is the case of the teachers that you have a separate service conditions, and every pay commission is usually one is tougher than the other. Every successive thing is tougher than the other. At this moment, you know, for any employee, including teachers, of course, what the salary would be, what the pension would be, and what would be the promotion schemes, these are very important things. And as far as the University of Delhi is concerned, thousands have not got their promotions. Over 4,000 teachers are acting on an ad hoc basis over here. And nearly 800 teachers are not getting their pension for the last few years. Added with it, the kind of policy attack that has come up. If the government does not change, if the UGC does not change their ways, what would the teacher do? I mean, to take a call for a strike, which I think is the most difficult decision that the teacher has to take. And we have tried our level best to get to the students, to talk to them, to students' organization. And as you're well aware, most students' organization, if not all, have come in solidarity with the kind of program that we had. And even then, of course, the government or the UGC had shown a bit of sympathy, I would say, but nothing concrete has come up. So in that sense, we were, you know, deeply, I would say, in agony also we had to go to take this step. It is not that we want to do it. The kind of scheme that is coming up, number one, there's a huge cut in the kind of grants that universities and colleges will get. They're saying that to get the grants for your infrastructure, and for infrastructure they would mean both the buildings and instruments, to get that you need to take a loan from the government. What they're saying is the loan, you have to give in a bit of said money, and within 10 installments in 10 years one has to return the principal amount. From where will we return this amount from? We will have to return this amount from the students, largely from the students. Any increase that will take place, whether it may be for the 70-30, if it is for our salaries, or if it is for infrastructure, this will be directly and adversely affecting the students. So from public funded institutions where you need more funds coming in to really compete with the kind of competition that we have today, what the government is doing is trying to say that go into the market and get it from the students, and largely from the students. And if the DUTA does not raise a voice, if teachers do not raise a voice, who will? And that is the very reason. And if you think of central universities, there's the added threat of a tripartite agreement which the central government is sending, and it has already sent to all the central universities, where a memorandum of understanding will be signed by the university and the college concerned, by the UGC and the MHRD, to say how we will raise the fees, user charges. If you look at the cases under the autonomous schemes, directly they are telling, come, open up self-financing courses, open up market-oriented courses. So what will happen? In these schemes, the teachers will not be permanent, and the students will have to pay exorbitant rates in comparison to the rates that they pay now at this moment. So again, as a responsible association, this is the most minimum thing that we could do. We are not saying that we are going to do it to the end, but if we do not raise a voice, and added with it is not only the policy of financial policy, the kind of policy changes they are trying to make with the reservation roster is also very important to us and very important to us. We have in this university itself advertisement for nearly 2,000 jobs, and which over a year now, and it will lapse in a few months. And only 2 appointments have been done in the colleges and 150 in the university. And now they want to change the roster. Once we change the roster, the whole thing will again come to a standstill. And for an ordinary teacher would feel, and especially an ordinary young teacher without a permanent job, would definitely is definitely feeling cheated that they have paid fees, application forms to fill for those jobs. And now they hear that the government has changed the reservation policy. And the reservation policy per se is anti SC, ST and OBC categories, and in the short run definitely against all teachers, even in the unreserved category, those who are teaching in an ad hoc position. At the level of less than 4%, that's what we are giving in the budget, and higher education being much lower. It is the whole education budget that we are talking about. 50, 60 years back, we used to talk about 6% of the GDP. Now we definitely want 10%, but we are not even at 25% of what we are demanding. You're very right when you say that for a country like India, we should be nearly at the level of 40% as far as the gross enrollment rate is concerned. And recent survey tells us it is around, what, 23? And if we do not pump in public funds into education, what will happen? If we raise our fees, who will go out? It would be not only the marginalized section, it will be also the girl students who will be moving out from higher education. There's a clear cut in the kind of society that we live in India. This is where it will affect. And so what is necessary is a huge, I would say, funds must be injected into the system. But this is what, you know, the kind of priorities the government has, it is not placing in, putting in the money where it should come in. So we need a lot many colleges, all kinds of colleges, and all over the country. Then only we can reach where we are aiming to. But that's not happening. And that is the main reason also that we are feeling that our policy makers are not doing the right thing. We realize that it is not only Delhi University or the central universities which can take up this fight alone. What has happened is that in this last few months, other universities are also taking it up. Members of parliament are raising questions. Few people in the government are also raising questions. I hope that civil society and the public at large would realize that the question that we are raising are, you know, they also feel that we are raising the right issue. And that will, I am sure, that will make the government think about the kind of policy that they have. We do realize that, of course, we are an important cog in the teachers' movement, DUTA, but we also know that only Delhi University doing it will not do. I hope that this will be taken up by one and all over the country, then only. So we are acting more like a roadblock, but an important roadblock. So, and knowing pretty well that the things will change when everyone over here in Delhi, maybe students are coming in, karamcharis are coming in, but we definitely would want it to be taken up, this issue to be taken up all over the country, and especially by our policymakers.